From digital voice assistants to smart home devices, artificial intelligence, AI, has quickly become an integral part of our everyday lives, a fact that has not escaped the notice of military establishments, both here and abroad. I've made many videos about various aspects of AI, while many other people have made videos about the potential dangers of AI, including popular movies from 2001 A Space Odyssey to The Terminator. I haven't spoken as much on the risks of AI because, while it is a powerful technology, it is not necessarily more or less dangerous than other technological revolutions. At the outset, who would have thought that the internet might lead to armed conflicts, or that the Industrial Revolution would lead to global warming with resultant weather turmoil and sea level rise? Recognizing the role AI potentially can play in changing the nature of war, the U.S. Department of Defense recently called for proposals to imagine the way in which AI will change decision-making on the battlefield. NATO, meanwhile, has already issued a set of short publications on the future of warfare, while both China and Russia are making significant investments in AI for national security purposes. All of this suggests that AI is likely to play a critical role in future conflicts. But what about the next phase of AI, AGI, Artificial General Intelligence? It's defined as the ability of an intelligent agent to understand or learn any intellectual task that a human can. AGI potentially could do everything from driving a car to performing a complex surgery at a consistently higher level than humans. It could also represent a huge national security risk if it were to fall into the wrong hands or be developed by a rogue nation. While some experts in the field predict AGI might take hundreds of years to emerge, if it emerges at all, I believe AGI is not only inevitable, but likely to occur within the coming decade. All that is really needed is the insight to understand how human-like intelligence works. To get there, though, researchers must shift their focus away from using ever-expanding datasets to support AI and concentrate instead on a more biologically plausible structure that enables AI to exhibit the same contextual common sense understanding that humans do. To that end, consider how the human brain works. The structure of the neocortex, the part of the brain we use to think, and the amount of DNA needed to define that structure may require as little as 7.5 megabytes of information, 1% of the human genome. Replicating a program of this size is well within today's programming abilities. Further, based on research on how biological neurons work, we likely already have more than enough computer power to achieve AGI. All that is missing is that insight into how the human brain works, and many, many researchers are working on this question, not necessarily for AGI, but also for the medical advances it will spin off. Today's AI can already exceed human mental performance, but still falls short in areas where any three-year-old can excel. Areas such as object persistence, three-dimensionality, the passage of time, and cause and effect are all fundamental to understanding. These have been sticking points for most AGI research to date. Let's face it, even if researchers had the insight to replicate the way in which the consciousness of a three-year-old works, three-year-olds typically need another 20 years or so before they have the knowledge and understanding to be fully functional and reasonably intelligent persons. Researchers simply don't want to wait 20 years. That explains why AGI emergence is likely to be gradual. Each step along the way will create capabilities that seem like good ideas and, as such, are individually marketable. An advance that helps a Siri or Alexa make fewer speech recognition errors might occur, and that development is rushed to market. Another advance produces better vision, enabling self-driving cars to be safer, and that development is rushed to market, too. While each of these developments is marketable on its own, if they are built on a common underlying data structure and attached to each other, they can begin to interact and build a broader context. Doing so will enable us to gradually approach AGI. At some point, we're going to get close to human level threshold, then we'll equal it and then exceed that threshold. And at some point, we're going to have machines that are so obviously superior to human intelligence that people will begin to agree that yes, maybe AGI does exist. AGIs will necessarily be goal-driven systems. In an ideal world, the people responsible for these thinking machines will ensure adequate safeguards so that the subsequent operation is safe. But what if the first owner of a powerful AGI system is a world power such as Russia or China, or worse, a rogue nation such as North Korea or Iran? While we will be able to program the motivations of the initial AGIs, we can't control the motivations of the people or countries or corporations that own them. This is an especially scary proposition. In a military context, computers will be in a position to recommend strategies, propose weapon systems, and evaluate competitive weaknesses. While it is unlikely that computers will be given absolute control over weapon systems, it is just as unlikely that they will be out of the loop on any significant decision. In decisions involving large amounts of information which must be balanced and predictions with multiple variables, the computer's ability will make them superior strategic decision makers. While such a scenario is alarming enough, I believe the greater threat comes from our computer's ability to sway opinion or manipulate markets. We have already seen efforts to control elections through social media, and AGI systems will make this vastly more effective. We have already seen markets at the mercy of program trading, and AGIs will amplify this issue as well. And we have already had hackers making cybersecurity a significant threat, even damaging physical infrastructure, and AGIs could do a much more efficient job of attacking lesser computer systems. To paraphrase concepts from nuclear deterrence to the NRA, the best way to stop a bad AGI is with a good AGI. As AGIs are inevitable and sooner than most people think, I see it as imperative that the West put a greater effort into broader AGI development rather than the haphazard approach of hoping that narrow AI systems will someday grow together into general intelligence. For national security reasons alone, it is incumbent on us to be the first to create AGI.
Future AI. Technologies that think.